of this long plant here that you see is called Curio radicans, and many of you might actually know this as Senecio radicans, otherwise known as fish hooks or string of bananas, and there's all different types of cultivars of these. So there's ones with like tinier little bananas, and there's ones with bigger bananas. This one's a more larger one. I've also seen ones that are a little bit more thicker leaved than this. So I have one of the smaller, thinner ones that's actually in hanging in my southwest facing window, and it's been hanging there for so much time within this kind of like macrame hanger with like two more plants in it that there was no way that I was going to get it out. So I ended up getting this one out because it was it was in a free hanging macrame hanger without any other ones attached to it, which is great. But these get quite long. They're great hanging basket plants. And if you have the light for it, like in a southern or western exposure, if you're in the northern hemisphere, then that's going to be perfect for this plant. Giving it even a little bit more top-down light will be able to keep some of the foliage up here on the top. Otherwise, if you're not giving it some of that light coming in, if it's not hitting it at a certain angle, then it'll start to actually maybe break away some of the leaves and start putting them down where most of the light is. This is actually a nice, really healthy specimen that I have here. I also have it in a Brunning pottery pot. So folks who have been asking me about where some of my planters are coming from, I get a lot of vintage planters, but I also get a lot from Brunning pottery is probably the one that I have the most planter pots from. And you can see they're all different and they're all really beautiful. Now, what else can I say about this plant? So much. This plant is originally native to kind of South Africa, Lesotho, I think maybe even up through some of Mozambique, if I'm not mistaken. And the way to propagate this plant is actually by taking some stem cuttings. That's actually some of the best ways. So if you're seeing that it's getting a little bit too long, take a tip cutting, let it dry out for like a day. And if it's balding on top, one of the things that I usually do is just kind of stick them back into the top. So it's almost like hair plugs, but for your plants. And that's gonna be great. I mean, you could already see from the color of this plant, that it's not like a dark green color. If we get out our Crayola crayons, we'd say, ooh, you know, maybe this is like this kind of verdigious, kind of glaucous kind of hue. And again, that would tell me the same thing that I already shared with you is that it's probably growing in a little bit more of a higher light condition because it has this kind of powdery, kind of green, pastel-y blue sheen to it, which is really nice. Doesn't need a tremendous amount of humidity. So if you have one of those dry homes, those dry, hot homes. Yeah, I'm talking about you, Arizona, and all those other states and the kind of like where you have like hot, intense, non-humid summers that feels like you're just in an oven baking. These plants are gonna be great. But you gotta make sure that you give them water too because they will have a tendency to dry out. One of the signs that these show, along with some of the other curios and the clineas, because a lot of senecios got kind of moved around, is that it starts to just pucker and maybe wrinkle a little bit. So make sure you give a thorough watering. I have a little bit of this in the potter's mix because when you actually take this out of a planter pot, you can't really get rid of a lot of that potting mix that comes with what the grower grew it in. But you'll also notice that I put a lot more perlite in this because I do like to give these a thorough watering. It goes right down into the basin if you overwater it. And you could kind of pour that out. And that way that you're giving this kind of thorough drink, the oxygen is moving through the soil and the plant is getting all that good stuff and any of the nutrients that you give it. Which again, that brings me to fertilizing because it's a succulent. You could probably get away on a monthly basis, although you might want to up that for a bi-weekly basis because these do put out a ton of leaves in the spring and summer months. So, and a lot of growth. As you can see, this one is very prolific and my other one is like nearly touching the floor. And you could give it a little bit more like a 2-4-7 or 3-4-7 or one of those succulent fertilizers. On this one, I actually have seen a little bit, not on this one in particular, but the one in my southwest facing window because it gets such a bombardment of light. I do have a tendency to get a little bit of spider mites on it, strangely enough, but it just perseveres with those spider mites. I'll hit it with a little bit of neem. You have to be careful with it because neem oil does defoliate some plants. So you want to test it out on your plants first, and you want to try to cover up your window or cover up the plant away from kind of any intense light, or do it on a day that is actually like today, which is overcast, so there's not sunlight coming in, because it could actually have some bad effects on the plant. So make sure you test it first. Don't, you know, you could follow what I say as like a guide, but not necessarily as gospel. And again, what works for you may not work for me, and vice versa. But this plant, it's been a great grower. I have several of them all throughout my house, but primarily in my southwest facing windows. And I can't wait to show you more. But this is Curio, formerly known as Senecio radicans.